السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My beloved brothers, sisters, today I just thought I'd talk about da'wah. I talk about da'wah. We all know da'wah, and we all know how broad the walk of reminding or calling people towards Islam, or calling people towards goodness, or calling people towards the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It is a big task. Not easy as you think, but at the same time there is so much reward you would gain, and at the same time there are so many challenges you have to face or go through, and at the same time you just become a great person and Allah blesses you and you feel the closeness to Allah because you have impacted on people's lives and you just are a good believer. So let's talk about, number one, how the sincerity that should be coming in terms of da'wah. When you call people towards Islam, or you call people towards goodness, one very important thing is the sincerity. You need to know it is for the sake of Allah, number one. You need to know you are not doing it expecting anything from someone. You have to cleanse your heart. You have to purify your intention. And you need to ask Allah to use you as a form or a means of guidance in terms of the deen. This is something that is very, very great. And we have to be careful at the same time. You see, Islam is very broad. A lot of us claim, I have knowledge, I am knowledgeable, I know what I'm doing. But you need to know, Islam is big and broad. You may think of something to be in a certain way, another person thinks of that thing to be in another way, but you all are fulfilling the same act of worship, and you both all have evidences backing up what you do. So how do you differ with people that say, I don't think you are correct, and you say, I don't think you are correct? My brother, you do what you think is correct. I'm gonna do what I believe is correct. You have your evidence, I have my evidence. We are all doing for the sake of Allah, and we are expecting our reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our deeds. That one, that's second thing. I spoke about sincerity. I spoke about differing with people in a respectful way. And now I want to talk about my beloved brothers and sisters. Wallahi, if you are not patient in terms of da'wah, if you are not patient in terms of calling or reminding people, you wouldn't last a day or two and it's over. People are gonna call you names, people are gonna abuse you, they swear you, they discourage you, they make you feel like you're wasting your time. But can I tell you where you should be achieving your comfort? If you look at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and how the same thing was done to him, they didn't want to listen. They threw stones at him in Ta'if. We know things like this and so many other things that happened. Yet he never gave up. He continued calling them. You look at the story of the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. Noah, may peace be upon him, 950 years. The same thing. Worship Allah, believe in Allah. They didn't want to listen. Did he give up? He never gave up. Why? Because he knew what he was doing. And he knew this is, you know, Allah has ordered him to do something. Allah has ordered you as well. You have knowledge. You have to teach people the knowledge. You have to use the knowledge you have. And then you have to be patient in terms of giving out that knowledge. So usually short reminders, I just thought we can talk about this. The work of da'wah is something that is very big, and There are so many challenges we face, and you never should be bothering yourself what people are going to say, because they would always say things. As you know, they come, they say things, they make you feel like you're wasting your time. But if you understand and realize it is for the sake of Allah, then you wouldn't stop. So these are important factors. We talk about sincerity, we talked about patience, and we talked about what else? So many things. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us patient as we go through things, the work of da'wah. And can I say one thing? Da'wah mustn't be always in the masjid or in the masajid. In everywhere you are, every place you are, every office you are, or anything, for you to promote good is a form of da'wah. For you to correct someone you see them do wrong is a form of da'wah. It doesn't mean you have to go to the masjid and you start shouting. No, da'wah is at different phases, different points, and just anyhow you believe you can impact positively, then you have to do what you can. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. You look at the verses that come in Surah As-Saff, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks beautifully, and I'd like to round up with these verses by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and these verses are very powerful and beautiful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى تِجَارَةٍ هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى تِجَارَةٍ تُنْجِيكُمْ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ تؤمنون بالله ورسوله وتجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالكم وأنفسكم ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون.
O you who believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, shall I guide you or show you towards a transaction that would save you from a painful torment or a painful punishment? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you believe in Allah and you strive with yourselves and your wealth in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hal adullukum ala tijaratin tunjikum min adhabin alim tu'minuna billahi wa rasulihi. You believe in Allah and His Messenger, wa tujahiduna fi sabilillahi bi amwalikum wa anfusikum, and then you strive in the cause of Allah with your selves and your wealth. Thalikum khayrul lakum in kuntum ta'lamun. That is indeed better if only you know. So part of da'wah, or part of striving in the cause of Allah with your own selves, is a form of da'wah. And the same applies to giving charity. I hope we've learned a lesson or two. Inshallah, would end and we meet another Friday, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.